Thank you. spirit of respect for one another, and out of the diversity of religious traditions out of which we come, let us pray. Gracious God, we welcome your presence with us today as we celebrate the dedication, hard work, and accomplishments of these graduates and of this institution. Show us where we need to go from here. On this day of endings and beginnings, we applaud the transmission of wisdom from one generation to the next, yet are awed by all that remains unknown. Encourage us always to dwell among those who savor beauty, practice truth, advance community, respond in compassion, are animated by wisdom not their own, empowered by a spirit they do not possess, and awed by mystery which defies comprehension. May this convocation ceremony give us renewed hope, courage, and energy. Amen.
Madam Chancellor, honored guests, honorary degree recipients, colleagues, graduates, family, and friends, good afternoon. Thank you for being here to share this special day of celebration. One of the great pleasures and privileges of being president of Mount St. Vincent is the opportunity to congratulate you, our graduates. Today, we celebrate the achievements of 553 graduates. Every one of you is a success story, and the Mount is proud of your success. Let's all take this opportunity to congratulate the spring 1997 graduating class. Like to take a moment to acknowledge those who have made this afternoon's convocation possible. Many people work hard to put this together. Dr. Rosemary Sampson, our Dean of Professional Studies, has overall responsibility for convocation, and many people work with her on the committee and throughout the university to make the arrangements. I'd also like to especially acknowledge our registrar, Lynn Terrio, who along with her staff goes through every graduating student's record to make sure that everyone who should be here is here, and that you will each take away all the appropriate parchments, honors, and plaudits which you have worked for and which you so richly deserve. We know the hard work that is required to earn the credentials awarded this afternoon, and families and friends of our graduates are well aware of the sacrifices and hard work which these outstanding women and men have made to be here today. Many of our graduates have performed an impressive juggling act, balancing studies and career responsibilities. For some students, these responsibilities include full and part-time work in the labor force, and for others, the responsibilities are full-time work in the home, raising a family, or caregiving, or contributing as volunteers to their community, often against the backdrop of marginal income support. Some of you may not know that more than 60% of Mount students are non-traditional, meaning they are 25 years of age or older, they are re-entering education, and they are pursuing their studies part-time. Many of our non-traditional students and many of today's graduates are working on second and even third credentials to adapt to the rapidly changing needs of the world and the workplace. Some of our graduates today are members of the Mount family. Mount employees like Sandra Clark, our payroll coordinator, who receives her Bachelor of Business Administration degree. Amy Gordon, our valedictorian this afternoon, receives her Bachelor of Science degree with first class honors and highest aggregate. Amy is the niece of Larry Hayes, a former board chair, who we are delighted to have with us. As I've said, each graduate is a success story, and we'll share some of those stories with you later in the program. As president, I'm very fortunate that so many students and alumni share with me stories of their experience at the Mount. And while each story is unique, there's a common thread that runs throughout. Mount St. Vincent University is a truly special place. What gives the Mount this distinction? Well, we are a very different kind of institution. The Mount is the only women's university in Canada. We are dedicated primarily to the higher education of women. 83% of our students are women, more than 60% of our faculty, and over 80% of our senior administrators. So our students have excellent role models. But our uniqueness is more than demographics. Because of our long history of educating women, nearly 125 years to be exact, and following in the footsteps of our founders, the Sisters of Charity, we've learned a thing or two about women's educational needs and how best to meet them. On Wednesday, we hosted a symposium on women's higher education. We were fortunate to have as guest speakers Dr. Jadwiga Sebrechts, the president of the Women's College Coalition, which is based in Washington, D.C., and Dr. Berit Ass, a distinguished Norwegian feminist and an honorary degree recipient of this institution. The symposium explored why women's colleges and universities still play a vital role in women's higher education. How vital is that role? Well, there's a very great deal of research which demonstrates the benefits to women of attending, for at least part of their education, as I did, a completely or primarily women's institution. It has been shown that they participate more fully, both inside and outside the classroom, have more opportunities to gain leadership experience, and are able to see women in a variety of roles, in a variety of positions. Of Business Week's list of the 50 women who are rising stars in corporate America, 30% of them received their bachelor's degree from a women's institution. Since women's university graduates account for less than 4% of university-educated women, they're overrepresented on this list by a factor of 6 to 1. 1/3 of the women board members of the Fortune 1000 companies are women's university graduates. Less than 1% of the highest paid officers and directors of these same Fortune 1000 companies are women, but more than 1/3 of them are graduates of women's universities and colleges. One of the reasons some people have said accounts for the success of women's college graduates is that those universities and colleges only admit wealthy students. Well, here at the Mount, as elsewhere in North America, approximately 50% of our students receive some form of financial aid. Another myth about women's colleges and universities is that they are male-free zones, and that therefore women students do not have a true representation of the real world. But in fact, at the Mount, we welcome male students and all students. Men represent 17% of our students, a pattern repeated among our sister institutions across North America. What is different about an environment like the Mount is that students can take these significant years of their education in an environment where women are in the majority. We are educating women and men to take action affirmatively for their own development. So the question remains, why do so many graduates of women's universities achieve outstanding results? I believe that personalized education and accessibility are the key. At the Mount, personalized education means more than small class sizes. It's our whole approach to treating students as individuals, to valuing their individual voices and experiences, to supporting and challenging each and every one of our students. Personalized education means that our faculty know students on a first-name basis and they take a personal interest in their success. They provide students with one-on-one academic advising and act as mentors and role models. Graduates, I'd like you to join me in expressing appreciation to our faculty. It is personalized education that truly transforms a university into a community. Mount St. Vincent also believes that a university education should be an attainable goal. We make higher education accessible through bridging programs offered by our Center for Continuing Education, through flexible class scheduling that better suits the needs of students with jobs and family responsibilities, through distance education delivery of many of our courses and programs. In fact, the Mount pioneered distance education in the Maritimes, and we continue to provide leadership in this area. Mount St. Vincent also incorporates a women's emphasis into its curriculum so that the perspectives and contributions of women can be recognized and discussed. And so our graduates have had the benefit of a truly unique university experience. And we at the Mount have had the benefit of the voices, views, and insights of the women and men who are graduating today. I think that's a mutually beneficial arrangement. Now, we all know that it takes teamwork to achieve goals, and I know that our graduates would also want me to acknowledge and join me in acknowledging the important contributions that you, their family members and friends, have played in making today possible. And now some special recognitions. At this morning's convocation ceremony, two of our faculty members were honored for respectively excellence in teaching and excellence in research. And while we won't go through the whole ceremony again, I am going to recognize each of them and ask them to stand so that you can see who they are and recognize their achievement. The Mount St. Vincent Alumni Award for Teaching went to Dr. Bly Frank of our Department of Education. Bly? Bly has been with the Mount since 1990 and is an internationally recognized educator and a specialist in gender, sexuality, schooling, and socio-educational theory. The first ever Mount Award for Research Excellence went to Dr. Peter Schwenger from our Department of English. Peter has been with the Mount since 1975, the author of two books and another one currently under review, and many essays. He has been recognized by his peers for his significant contribution to research at this university and through other awards for his contribution to scholarship in English studies in Canada. Dr. Elizabeth Bellefontaine, who retired last year, was recently named Professor Emeritus by our Senate. Sister Betty. Sister Betty, as she is affectionately known by all of us, joined the Mounts Department of Religious Studies in 1965, served as a member of our board and Senate, and from 1975 on coordinated the annual Elizabeth Seton Lectures at the Mount. She is currently working as part of the leadership team with our Chancellor, Sister Mary Louise Brink, as a member of the Sisters of Charity Leadership Group. I'd also like to acknowledge faculty member Dr. Donald Smith, who will retire shortly from the Mount. Dr. Smith joined the Mount in 1986 and helped to establish our Tourism and Hospitality Management Program. He chaired the department for many years, and in addition to his teaching and administrative work, was actively involved in research in the areas of food technology and catering services. Best wishes for your retirement, Don. Mount St. Vincent is on the eve of our 125th anniversary, but this current year holds many highlights too. In September, we introduced an undergraduate program in peace and conflict studies and a master's in women's studies jointly with Dalhousie and St. Mary's Universities. We have many partnerships with our sister institutions, both within and outside the Metro Halifax Universities Consortium. Partnership has been a long-standing tradition at Mount St. Vincent. And speaking of anniversaries, this year marks the 25th anniversaries of our business administration program, the 25th anniversary of our art gallery, the 20th anniversary of our child study center, and the 5th anniversary of our Center for Women in Business. We celebrate many individual accomplishments too. One of our public relations students, Andrea Baldwin, was recently named Cooperative Education Student of the Year by the Canadian Association for Cooperative Education. And that's not just a Mount or a regional award, that's for the whole country. Also, four Mount students were selected by Walt Disney World for the World Showcase Representative Program at Epcot Center. Two of these students, business student Margaret Mooland and tourism and hospitality management student Jonathan Chang, were chosen for Disney's prestigious World Showcase Fellowship Program, a 12-month educational and cultural exchange. On this day of celebrating successes, the Mount community can be proud of all that we are and of where we are going. The Mount is a university with a clear mission and mandate, and it is this clarity which gives us guidance and direction through these rapidly changing times. Certainly, the threat of further cuts in government funding is worrisome to the Mount, given our dedication to accessibility and to offering students a true alternative. The Mount's distinctive role is recognized far and wide. Only 2 months ago, the Public Broadcasting Network in Ontario showed a documentary on women's education that featured glowing coverage of the contribution the Mount makes. And many national media have cited us as a university like no other in Canada. It is our wish that we be equally appreciated here at home. Graduates, in your new role as Mount alumni, you will be effective goodwill ambassadors for the university. I urge you to spread the word about Mount St. Vincent. Ultimately, your success and the contributions you make to your profession and your communities will be the most positive reflection of our success in helping you achieve your life's goals. I wish you all well.
Madam Chancellor, distinguished guests, professors, fellow graduates, family, and friends. I can't help remembering the day 5 years ago when my mom left me at Assisi Hall. As I watched her drive away, I suddenly felt more lonely and afraid than I ever had before. I'd made the decision to come to Nova Scotia from Ontario because I wanted to make a fresh start in a new place, but suddenly I wondered what on earth I had done. However, I soon discovered that there is an incredible sense of community here at the Mount. I made many lasting friendships that week, and I'm even still good friends with someone I met the very first day. Now I feel as if I'm leaving home again. What makes this sense of community truly amazing is the fact that the Mount is made up of such a diverse group of people. Some of us came here directly out of high school, while others came back after many years in the workforce. Some of us are single and childless, while others have children and families to take care of. Most of us are women, but I think I had a man in one of my classes a couple of years ago. When I looked around my classrooms, it was hard to believe that I would have much in common with all of these people. But perhaps because we are such a diverse group, we were able to develop a more understanding attitude and to draw together. We each had our own unique problems and worries, from wondering if we could afford next year's tuition, to wondering if we could stand yet another night of craft dinner, from wondering if we could find daycare for our kids, to wondering if we could afford to go to Vinny's this week. But we also faced many common challenges, and perhaps these were the ones that reminded us that we weren't so different after all. The towering mountain of coursework, the all-nighters, the mutant fungus in Rosaria, and let's not forget climbing up and down those lovely hills. Even more importantly, together we were able to benefit from the unique learning environment that the Mount provides. The Mount's focus on women gave both women and the welcome, if rare, men in our classes, new perspectives on gender issues. Our small class sizes promoted discussion and debate. We enjoyed a flexible learning environment which could be tailored to our individual needs and interests. Even more importantly, however, we were assured personal contact with our professors. Our professors genuinely cared about our progress and actively guided and assisted us. Of course, that also meant that they expected a lot from us and set high standards for us to meet. It was a challenging few years, but now we've made it. It is time to leave and to continue on our very divergent paths. We leave as very different people from whom we were when we first arrived at the Mount. We survived those days when we didn't think we could possibly make it. We're stronger and more confident. We've become more tolerant of people who are different from ourselves. In short, we leave here prepared for the challenges that lie before us. Good luck to my fellow graduates, and thank you to all who have helped me to reach this day of celebration.
Madam Vice Chancellor and President, it is my privilege to present to you the candidates for the Collegiate Honors of Graduation. I attest that they have successfully completed required courses of study, and I ask that they be awarded the Certificate in Business Administration. Deborah Lee Brown. Catherine Kaye. Brian Gregory McLeod. Madam Chancellor, the Certificate in Gerontology on Mary Paula Barry. Mabel E. McCacken. Jocelyn Diane McLeod. Eileen Nickerson. Cynthia Doreen Pfeiffer. Mary Lou Robertson. Patricia Lee Waterhouse. Madam Chancellor, it is my privilege to present to you the candidates for the Collegiate Honors of Graduation. I attest that they have successfully completed the required courses of study and that I ask that they be admitted to the baccalaureate degree. Madam Chancellor, Madam President, I'm going to change the order a little bit here. I have a student here who some unnamed airline changed all of her plans on her, has wreaked havoc in her life all week, has a flight around 4:15, and I promised her that she could walk across the stage. And it's Cheryl Little, right? Bachelor of Business Administration, and I believe it's with distinction. And she's also the recipient of the Society of Management Accountants of Nova Scotia Award. Congratulations.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Madam Chancellor, it is my privilege to present you the candidates for the Collegiate Honors of Graduation. I attest that they have successfully completed the required courses of study, and I ask that they be admitted to the baccalaureate degree. Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Bachelor of Science. Oh, business diplomas. Jocelyn Courage. This is it. And Stephen Longdon. That was the diploma in business administration, and now we'll do the Bachelor of Science degree. Sarah Brownlow.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Science with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations, Sarah.
Jennifer Lynn Cummings.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Rebecca Catherine Dawson.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science. Congratulations, Rebecca.
Dorothy Ann Dennis.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science. Congratulations.
Roberta Maria DeQuinzio, graduating with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science. Congratulations.
Claudette Eade, also graduating with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science. Congratulations.
Rebecca Lynn Fountain, graduating with distinction and highest aggregate. She also held Mount St. Vincent University Diamond Jubilee Presidential Award.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Claudette Mary Frizzell.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Marlene Teresa George.
confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Michelle Irene Gilmet.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Nadine Patricia Hensby.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Congratulations. Kelly Christine Hill.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Congratulations.
Kathy Griffiths Hodley.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Congratulations.
Robin Ruth Johnson, graduating with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Congratulations.
Natasha Ann King.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Heather Kingston.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Juanita M. Lane.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Angela Dawn Langell.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Jennifer Marie McIsaac, graduating with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Congratulations.
Jacqueline Dawn McLeod.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Terry McNamara.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Clausina Elizabeth Meyer McKinnon.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Jean Mary Miller.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Rochelle Jacqueline Parley.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Dawn Arlene Porter.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Shy Elizabeth Rhino.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Allison Rossiter.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Cheryl Terrio.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Wendy Lee Westhaver.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Carol Ann White.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Sheila Louise Zink.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Madam Chancellor, Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Bachelor of Science Honors on Karen Michelle Cooper.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Science Honors with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Congratulations.
Sandra Eves with first class honors, and she's also the recipient for 1997 of the Sarah E. Phillips Memorial Prize in Mathematics.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science honors.
Congratulations.
Amy Elizabeth Gordon with first class honors and highest aggregate. She also held a Mount St. Vincent University Diamond Jubilee Presidential Award, has also held a Canada Scholarship.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science Honors.
Krista Bernice Corkum with first class honors.
confer the degree of Bachelor of Science Honors. Congratulations.
Catherine Diane Brown. This degree is given jointly by Mount St. Vincent University and Dalhousie University, and Catherine has been accepted to do her master's degree in chemistry at the University of Waterloo.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science Honors given jointly by Mount St. Vincent University and Dalhousie University.
Congratulations.
And Madam Chancellor, an honors certificate is being given to Wendy Marie LaForce. Wendy has been accepted into the Department of Microbiology and Immunology at Dalhousie University to study at the graduate level with Dr. Thomas Izukuts.
I confer the honors certificate in science.
Congratulations.
Madam Chancellor, Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Bachelor of Applied Arts Information Management on Margot Fitzpatrick Practica Route.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Applied Arts Information Management with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Donna Teresa Genereau with distinction and practica route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Applied Arts Information Management.
Catherine Lynn Hartland with distinction and highest aggregate, also practica route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Applied Arts Information Management.
Sherry A. Robley, Cooperative Education option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Applied Arts, Information Management.
Beth Turner, Practica Route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Applied Arts, Information Management.
Congratulations.
Madam Chancellor, Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Bachelor of Office Administration on Sandra Harnum.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Office Administration with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration on Zahi A. Hadar.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Francois Bork with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Nancy Arlene Bowden.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Congratulations.
David Michael Bryan.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Congratulations.
Kenneth William Campo with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Ken is the recipient of the Farmers Cooperative Dairy Limited Prize in Marketing. Michelle E. Chapman.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Congratulations.
Sandra Clark.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Congratulations.
Mark Clyde Cooper, Cooperative Education option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Congratulations, Mark.
Andre Corkum.
Okay. I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration. Congratulations.
Claudine Ann Crowell.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Paula Crowell.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Congratulations, Carl.
Juanita Lorraine Domini with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Trudy Doucette with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Cindy Ann Downard.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Congratulations, Cindy.
Raquel Patrice Emery.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Paula Marie Ferguson.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Elaine Elizabeth Ann Foley.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Catherine Foote.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Scott Frizzell.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Jennifer Ann Gale.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Karen Lisa Olding Hebb.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Shauna Ann Hopkins.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Congratulations, Shauna.
Wayne Keddy.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Congratulations.
Nigel Kelly.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Jennifer Kingston.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Patricia Lynn McDonnell.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Gerald Joseph McKenzie.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Heidi Jane Michelson.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Sarah Jane Napier.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Rebecca Ann Nelson.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Susan Carol Nelson with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Nicole Maria Pacheco.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Joyce Elizabeth Pinkham.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Veronica Gail Elliott.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
George Major Scarry.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Barbara Sabaskovich with distinction. Barbara is the recipient of the Ted Osborne Memorial Prize.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Bruce Thompson with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Heather Tufts.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Catherine Waugh with distinction and highest aggregate.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
Madam Chancellor, the Bachelor of Business Administration degree with first class honors on Zeeshan Hashim Najmuddin, Cooperative Education option. He received the Swiss Ambassador's Award in German.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration honors with first class honors, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Congratulations.
Madam Chancellor, Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Bachelor of Human Ecology on Shannon Lee Clark.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Human Ecology with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Congratulations.
Leslie Ann Davidson.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Jennifer Kelly Davini, with distinction and highest aggregate, also cooperative education option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Jennifer Lynn Keeping, cooperative education option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Jody Lynn McCachran.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Human Ecology.
Congratulations, Jody.
Jean Monique Mullins with distinction and cooperative education option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Human Ecology.
Margaret Davilia Nash.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Madam Chancellor, Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Bachelor of Human Ecology with first class honors on Stacy Lee Cronin.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Human Ecology honors with first class honors, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Congratulations.
Madam Chancellor, Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology on Vanessa Jane Allen.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Congratulations.
Scott Andrew Boucher with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Heather Elaine Brown with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Shelley Lynn Casey.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Jennifer Leslie Coombs with distinction, cooperative education option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Lisa Marie Dixon, with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Lorianne Doucette.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Natasha Dunn, with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Denise Nanette Elliott, with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Jennifer Kim Ferguson, with distinction and cooperative education option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Karen Marie Gillis, with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Linda Diane Hurley.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Stacy Leanne Jewett.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Rebecca Jane LeBlanc, with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Stacy Ludington. Stacy also receives the certificate in business today.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Kristen Natalia McCacken.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Shannon Maureen McEwen, with distinction and cooperative education option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Deborah Ann McMillan.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Kelly Marie McCarroll.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Candace Dawn Melbourne.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Floria Mersaga.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Tanya Nickel.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Naomi Ann Oxner, who also receives the certificate in business.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Shauna Lee Power.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations, Shauna.
Margot Reeby Butt, with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations, Marco.
Jennifer Helen Roma.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
April Dawn Rushton.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Jacqueline Ann Sparks, with distinction and cooperative education option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology.
Congratulations.
Madam Chancellor, Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology with first class honors on Michelle Lynn Cleveland.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Science in Human Ecology with first class honors, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Madam Chancellor, Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations on William Albert Adams.
The Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Yasmin Anissa Ali.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Linda Marie Ashford.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Lori Ann Baglow.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Mary Teresa Benson, Cooperative Education Officer.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Kelly Ann Bent.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations. Congratulations.
Krista Blakey, Cooperative Education Option with Distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Daryl Joseph Braun Miller, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Jody Marie Bryan, Cooperative Education Option with Distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Shauna Marie Bryden.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Carolyn Chaplin, Cooperative Education Option with Distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations. Anita Louise Chapman, Cooperative Education Option with Distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Stacy Dawn Chapman.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Jennifer Cormier.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations.
Connie Ann Crocker.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations, Connie.
Bruce DeBay with Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations, Bruce.
Nancy Dory with Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations.
Heather Doucette.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations, Heather.
Craig Duhamel, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations.
Natalie Dawn Fraser, Cooperative Education Option with Distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations, Natalie.
Sarah Genevieve Germain with Distinction, Cooperative Education Option. Sarah also receives the certificate in business today.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations.
Jane Margaret Hawksworth.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations, Jane.
Susan Henniger, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Suzanne L. Hickey, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Frank Howell.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations, Frank.
Heather Hurst, Cooperative Education Option with Distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations.
Valerie Jean Jewell.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Lori Knickel, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations,
Jody Lynette MacArthur.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Ashley Ann McGinnis, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Stephanie McWhirter.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations.
Shelley Ann Manderville.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Kimberly Ann McCoe, who also receives a business certificate.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Jacinta Noonan, with distinction and highest aggregate.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Kathy Ann O'Brien, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Margaret Rose Perry.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Rajpal Rai, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Jennifer Lynn Ryan.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Sharon M. Ryan, with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Mary Beth Saulnier.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations,
Mary. Lena Sletvold.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Carla Stevens, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Melanie Dawn Talyard. Melanie also receives the certificate in business today.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations, Melanie.
Julie Germaine Van Rickerborsel, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Darcy Roy Truen, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Congratulations.
Beverly Joanne Warford.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Laura Michelle Wilkinson, Cooperative Education Option.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Jason Allen Wingo.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Monica Jean Wyman.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Public Relations.
Madam Chancellor, Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management on Tammy O'Coyne, Cooperative Education Route. Tammy also receives the certificate in business today.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Congratulations, Tammy.
Philip Chesson, Cooperative Education Route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Stephanie Robin Crawford, Cooperative Education Route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Congratulations.
Lima Agnes Frederick, Cooperative Education Route, with distinction. Lima also receives the certificate in business today.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Congratulations.
Andrea Joy Gould. Andrea also receives the certificate in business today, Cooperative Education Route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Congratulations, Andrea.
Kathy Ann Hayward, Cooperative Education Route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Brenda Lee Hogan, Cooperative Education Route. Brenda also receives the certificate in business.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Congratulations, Brenda.
Heather Lorraine McKenzie, Cooperative Education Route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Congratulations.
Alana Denise McLeod, Cooperative Education Route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Dean Spencer Martin, Cooperative Education Route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Stacy McKeel, Practica Route. Stacy also receives a certificate in business today.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Dale Palmeter, Cooperative Education Route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Suzanne Reynolds, Cooperative Education Route. Suzanne also receives her certificate in business today.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Congratulations, Suzanne.
Nancy Anna Westhaver, Cooperative Education Route with distinction.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Tammy Rosamond White, Practica Route. Tammy also receives a certificate in business today.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Krista Dawn Williams, Cooperative Education Route.
I confer the degree of Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management.
Madam Chancellor, I attest that the following students have successfully completed the required courses of study, and I ask that they be admitted to the master's degree. Mount St. Vincent University confers the degree of Master of Human Ecology on Alana Robb.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you to the degree of Master of Human Ecology with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Congratulations.
Lori Ann Carroll Fulmer.
I confer the degree of Master of Human Ecology.
Madam Chancellor, I ask that you confer the appropriate degrees on all those presented to the University Senate who are not here this afternoon.
I confer degrees in absentia on those persons so designated by the dean.
Now, we've all been sitting for a long time. If you turn to page 30 in your programs, and all show that you're such great Latin scholars, we're going to sing Gaudeamus, so why don't we all stand to give ourselves a little break? And Don Yakov will lead us. Dr. Wayne Ingalls, Vice President Academic, will present the Senate Medals of Distinction. These engraved pewter medals awarded by the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University are given in recognition of superior academic achievement to each student who graduates with distinction and with highest aggregate in undergraduate diploma and degree programs. This year's recipients are Rebecca Lynn Fountain, Bachelor of Science with Distinction. Rebecca graduated today with a major in psychology, and all of her psychology professors agree that she's an outstanding student. They think she has a phenomenal memory coupled with excellent study skills. They marvel that she can always be there in class, hanging on to every word, hardly ever taking a note, and coming out on top of the class. The department awarded her the Rudy Kafer Award for the best research proposal and poster presentation in the advanced methods class. Last year, Rebecca worked part-time at a senior citizens home, and this year she worked in the Mounts Play Gym, in a program where infants and small children were engaged while their mothers exercised. Rebecca is hoping to study occupational therapy at Dalhousie. Amy Elizabeth Gordon, Bachelor of Science Honors in Biology with First Class Honors. Just to spare Amy from coming down the second time, we'll also give her the valedictorian prize. Amy, an undergraduate Canada scholar in science and engineering, is a superior student. and her professors indicate the word superior does not do her justice. They note her intellectual curiosity and ability, and they have been impressed with her willingness to do what is appropriate to further her academic career. By nature, a shy person, when Amy realized that oral presentations before large groups would be required, she enrolled in a public speaking course without prompting. She is now such a polished presenter that faculty scheduled her in early as an example of how it should be done. Amy also participated in other aspects of university life other than academic. She has been the Vice President of Finance for the Business Society, a member of the English Society, of the Science Society, and was its treasurer and vice president. For the Science Society, she arranged a fundraiser in support of research on Alzheimer's disease. Her interests and activities outside the university have been wide-ranging, from astronomy — she frequently attends planetarium shows — piano playing, swimming, birding, aerobics, and dance classes. Amy has been awarded a National Science and Engineering Research Council postgraduate scholarship and a president's scholarship at the University of Western Ontario, where she will study, I think, avian memory? Bird's memory. Congratulations, Amy. Catherine Lynn Hartland, Bachelor of Applied Arts, Information Management. Kathy came to the Department of Information Management in 1993 with a Bachelor of Commerce from Dalhousie University. In addition to her superb academic record, her performance in practicum was outstanding. Her level of knowledge and her capabilities have been recognized by the number of requests she has received for tutoring and small group training. Kathy assisted the Dean of Arts and Science, also the editor of the calendar, in a major updating of the university calendar this past year. She not only provided technical expertise, but also actively contributed many ideas as to how to improve the calendar's appearance. Her employers note her reliability and unfailing attention to detail. Having grown and developed during her years here, we know that she will be a valuable asset to any organization that hires her. Congratulations, Kathy. Catherine Waugh, Bachelor of Business Administration. Kathy was admitted to the Certificate in Business Administration program in 1992, a step many non-traditional students take on beginning business studies at the Mount. She excelled from the start and decided not to stop at the certificate. She was admitted to the degree program in 1995 and made a commitment to enroll full time. She chose accounting as her concentration and has demonstrated an exceptional facility for the subject. Kathy, a busy mother and wife, has successfully integrated her studies with her home life. She did not limit herself to studying accounting exclusively. She added a financial investment course to her electives, and Kathy was one of the first students to enroll in the business consultancy course this winter. This course teaches students how to integrate their business studies and working with the Mount Center for Women in Business to apply their knowledge to developing a business plan for business startup. Congratulations, Kathy. Zeeshan Nujmuddin, Bachelor of Business Administration, First Class Honors. Zeeshan, originally from Karachi, Pakistan, has lived in Bedford the last several years. He graduates today with an Honors Bachelor of Business Administration degree, majoring in marketing, with a cooperative education option and first class honors. Zeeshan completed work terms with Nova Scotia Power and the Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce. His duties involved customer service, web page development, and the development of marketing information systems. His honors thesis addressed the use of the internet in marketing local firms. His work has already resulted in research opportunities and requests for information from the private sector. Zeeshan has applied to Harvard University, where he plans to pursue a master's degree in business administration. Congratulations, Zeeshan. Bachelor of Human Ecology, Jennifer Deviney. Jennifer graduated with a Bachelor of Human Ecology and Family Studies with a cooperative education option. Throughout her years of study at the Mount, Jennifer demonstrated that she is able to balance academic requirements, cooperative education work terms, with parenthood. Throughout it all, Jennifer maintained excellent grades, continued meaningful activity in the community in family studies, and contributed with her work term placements to the community with the Dartmouth Titans Gymnastics Club and the Nova Scotia Boys and Girls Club, where she received glowing work term evaluations from her employers. Through this, she parented her young son, Nathan. In the past year, Jennifer even found time to devise and write a column in the Pickerel, the Mount student newspaper, discussing the lives of student parents. Congratulations, Jennifer. Stacy Lee Cronin, Bachelor of Human Ecology Honors. Stacy graduates today with her honors degree. Her thesis, Taking Care of Their Own, Military Wives and Their Experiences with Formal and Informal Support Services, was an outstanding piece of work. Stacy's academic proficiency is equally matched by a corresponding commitment to service. For a number of years, Stacy has served as a support person to mentally and physically challenged individuals living in group homes. In addition, Stacy readily assumed a leadership role among her peers during her years at the Mount. She is a very good listener who provides support and encouragements to her classmates. Stacy personifies a caring and committed attitude, as well as the drive and the dedication to excel. Congratulations, Stacy. Michelle Lynn Cleveland, Bachelor of Science, Human Ecology Honors. Lynn has been an excellent student throughout her time at the Mount. She took great initiative this year in completing an extremely challenging research project for her honors thesis entitled Stimulation of the Immune System by Beta-Lactoglobulin. This work demonstrated a great deal of academic growth in developing a sound understanding of applied biochemistry. Lynn's academic success has been achieved while juggling the demands of a heavy part-time workload. Later this year, Lynn will be starting her dietetic internship at the Queen Elizabeth II Health Science Center. She is expected to continue to exhibit the leadership qualities that she has consistently shown at the Mount. Congratulations, Lynn. The highest aggregate in the Bachelor of Public Relations is shared by two students, one in absentia, who is Sarah Chamberlain, and also by Jacinta Noonan. An excellent student, Jacinta has been a student leader and active member of the Public Relations Society during her 4 years at the Mount. She has also been an active volunteer within the community and on campus. Volunteerism and community activity is nothing new to Jacinta. She was very active in her native PEI, volunteering for the Canadian Cancer Society and the Heart and Stroke Foundation. While here, she has been extremely active with the Alzheimer's Society. Congratulations, Jacinta. After the student walked across the stage, I noticed that on her card she did not have highest aggregate, but we will recognize her now. Lima Agnes Frederick, Bachelor of Tourism and Hospitality Management. Lima came to the Mount from Grenada in 1994 with transfer credits from the Barbados Community College and the Grenada National College. Her professors note that she was very serious about her studies and excelled from the start. As is required in the Tourism and Hospitality Management Program, Lima completed cooperative education work terms, hers with the Ashburn Golf and Country Club and the Dartmouth Visitor and Convention Bureau, and won awards for her, from her academic department for the most outstanding co-op work term report. Her employers commented very favorably on her enthusiastic and pleasant nature, her strong work ethic, and her dependability. She has consistently achieved Dean's List standing and was the recipient of the Dr. E. Margaret Fulton Scholarship for Academic Excellence. Congratulations, Lee. I have already recognized Sarah Chamberlain, who is not with us today. There are two other students who receive Senate medals. They are Monique Ann DeWinter, Bachelor of Science, Human Ecology with distinction, and Hugh Joseph Farrell, Diploma in Business Administration. President's Prize. These special awards, donated by the university president, are awarded to the members of the graduating class who have given evidence of best fulfilling the university's ideals of self-sacrifice and all-around cooperation, and who give promise of continued loyalty to the alma mater. Our first prize goes to Jacinta Noonan, Bachelor of Public Relations. Little to what I've already said. Jacinta comes from Albany, PEI, and like many PR students, she has taken her academic excellence beyond the classroom. I've already said she's been an active volunteer both on campus and in the community. She's been the co-president of the Public Relations Society, she edited the Society's newsletter, and organized the annual Public Relations Soiree. She has been an active volunteer for the Alzheimer's Society of Nova Scotia during her 4 years at the Mount. She has helped coordinate several fundraising campaigns, prepared media kits, edited publications for the association, and has written many articles for their newsletter. She organized Mount students to participate in their annual door-to-door campaign. At home in PEI, she still is involved in volunteerism, I think when she goes home, with the Heart and Stroke Foundation and the Canadian Cancer Society. We applaud her generous spirit and know that she will be a devoted alum of the Mount. Congratulations, Jacinta. Donna Jennerer, Bachelor of Applied Arts, Information Management. Donna's been at the Mount for a while. She's gone through a few transformations, but she graduates today in information management. She is a mature student who took a leave of absence for the provincial government, and she is returning to the Department of Economic Renewal, I believe. Donna received the American Record Management Association Scholarship in 1996, one of two students in Canada to receive the award. She has also received the Halifax Chapter Scholarship. Donna has done a great deal of work for the university, working in the Registrar's Office, the Communications Office, and has acted as the driving force getting the university's record management program off to an excellent start. Donna was told in high school that she was definitely not university material. She has set as her goal to prove everything and everyone wrong. And we would conclude that she has been successful. Best wishes. Congratulations. Gamma Pi. Membership in Kappa Gamma Pi, Honor Society of Catholic Universities for Women, is awarded to graduates who, in addition to high scholastic standing and a good record in extracurricular activities, give promise of academic leadership in the future. The award goes to Nancy Dory, Bachelor of Public Relations. Nancy came to the Mount after completing an English degree at Dalhousie and working in the nonprofit sector. Her positions at the Multiple Sclerosis Society and the Heart and Stroke Foundation piqued her interest in public relations and led her to believe that this was the field for her. Nancy tackled her courses and co-op assignments with enthusiasm, demonstrating that she has the skills and the aptitude to make a contribution in the classroom and in the workplace. While at the Mount, Nancy was involved with the Public Relations Society, working with the newsletter and alumni development committees. She continued to volunteer with the Heart and Stroke Foundation and the Multiple Sclerosis Society. In her earlier days, you would have found Nancy in the choir for the Nova Scotia International Tattoo. Nancy's co-op work terms took her to Toronto, where she had the opportunity to learn from Public Relations co-op graduates Annette Martel and Patricia Murphy Globe at Doan Raymond, and with the communications professionals at Naranda Incorporated. Her employers describe her as one who actively seeks feedback, demonstrates initiative, contributes much to the team and the company. The consensus of her co-op employers is that Nancy is going places. In fact, Courtney Pratt, president of Naranda, states that she has the potential to be a real star. Nancy is on her way back to Naranda to assume a communications position with Naranda Forest, and we wish her every success. Congratulations. The Governor General's Medal. A silver medal donated by His Excellency, the Governor General of Canada, is given to an undergraduate for the highest academic aggregate in the senior year. For 1997, the silver medal is awarded to Amy Gordon, Bachelor of Science, Honors Biology, with first class honors. Wanted to spare you a walk down three times. Just another piece of evidence to show what a remarkable young woman Amy is. Amy this past year received A pluses in all of her courses both at the Mount and at Dalhousie. We know that she will have a bright future in science, and we trust that she in her term will mentor other young women in their science careers. Congratulations once again.
Madam Chancellor, distinguished guests, graduates, and parents, it is an honor and a pleasure to present Susan Patten for the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa. We honor Susan Patten today because of her long and distinguished career as an extraordinary entrepreneur, leader, volunteer, role model for women in business. What is striking about Ms. Patten is her quiet demeanor and her modesty. These qualities seem almost unusual for a woman of her stature. But there are many things about Susan Patten that are far from ordinary. Susan Patten graduated from King's Hall in Compton, Quebec in 1950. King's Hall was an all-female institution, the place where she learned how to express her opinions, assert herself, and develop leadership skills. As the only child of Newfoundland businessman Reginald C. Harvey, it was presumed she would carry on the family business. She claims that she learned about business on her father's knee. When you ask Ms. Patten about her accomplishments, she simply says that what she has accomplished is nothing special. It was merely a matter of opportunity. However, a review of her many achievements demonstrates uncommon talent and dedication. Susan Patten joined the board of directors of A. Harvey & Company Limited in 1976, rising to the level of chair of the board in 1984. Today, she oversees a network of many companies, including A. Harvey & Company Limited, Browning Harvey, the Pepsi 7-Up and Cadbury bottler, Harvey Offshore Services Limited, Harvey Auto Carriers, Harvey's Oil Limited, Argentia Freezers and Terminals, and Avalon Custom Brokers. These companies have thrived under her leadership. A. Harvey & Company Limited has risen to distinction as one of the top 20 Atlantic Canadian companies for sales, with revenues of over $115 million. This firm also ranks number 10 in the top 20 companies for job growth, increasing employment by 19% during a period of record unemployment. Susan's accomplishments go beyond the boardroom. In addition to raising four children, her many quiet accomplishments have included member of the board of the Bank of Canada, member of the Newfoundland and Labrador Economic Council, member of the Joseph R. Smallwood Heritage Foundation, treasurer of the National Council of the Girl Guides of Canada, provincial commissioner of the Canadian Girl Guides, and chair of the Lieutenant Governor's Family Life Institute. And she is treasurer of the World Association of Girl Guides and Girl Scouts, and she is the first person in that post to be based outside of England. Susan Patten symbolizes the values of Mount St. Vincent University: community service, professional excellence, personal growth and development, and dedication to the family. In light of these things, and for her many uncommon achievements, I ask you, Madam Chancellor, in the name of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, to confer upon Susan Patten the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters honoris causa.
On behalf of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you, Susan Patten, to the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Chancellor, it's a pleasure to present to you Barbara Barde for the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters honoris causa. A few years ago, Barbara Barde conducted a national talent search for potential young videographers in preparation for a series called Road Movies to be shown on CBC television. In an interview, she described the qualifications she was looking for: young people with an insatiable curiosity, a sense of humor, and a passion for telling stories. The description applies admirably to Barbara herself. She's a passionate storyteller. As an independent television and film producer, she has produced and directed a wide range of thought-provoking programs that address contemporary social issues. In an industry well known for its mind candy, she has not shrunk from the stories that might make us uncomfortable or those that might challenge our assumptions and our attitudes. Our Daughter's Pain, a documentary on female genital mutilation, won B'nai B'rith's Media Human Rights Award in 1995. Last year, her documentary on racism in the media won a gold medal at the New York Film and Video Festival in the social issues category. As the founding vice president of programming for the Women's Television Network, she not only has helped to assemble and create programming that speaks to women's issues and concerns, but has provided an opportunity for women writers, directors, and producers to gain solid career experience. The quality of her work has been recognized by a long list of awards and honors. In 1989, she was named an outstanding filmmaker by Toronto Women in Film and Television. In 1994, she received the Dodie Robb Award
joining women such as Doris Anderson and Michelle Landsberg, who have been catalysts for change in the communications field. Last year, her series Girl Talk, which airs on WTN, was nominated for a Gemini Award. In the words of one Toronto journalist, she is a compelling combination of social activism and entrepreneurial smarts. For her vision, her pluck, and her commitment to raising the standard of Canadian broadcasting over the past 20 years, I ask you, Madam Chancellor, in the name of the Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, to confer upon Barbara Barde the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa.
Senate of Mount St. Vincent University, I admit you, Barbara Barde, to the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Told me I had to give the cape back at the end. First of all, I'd like to thank Marie for those kind and generous words of introduction. I want to begin by thanking the University Senate for bestowing this degree upon me. I am deeply honored. I'm equally honored to be able to speak here today. It is not often that one is asked to reflect upon one's whole life and then share those intimate reminiscences and thoughts with about 500 people. Live, without benefit of an editor, no commercial break, and not even a laugh track. The least you can grant me is only to think about the good times, because I can't go back into the editing room. And believe me, I've had a great life, but there have also been failures. And in my business, those failures are captured on film forever. So today, I ask your indulgence. I will stick to the highlights. I have sat where you are today, and I remember thinking, career, I must have a career. Future, I must have a future. Life, I must have a life. I was completely panicked. So what did I do? I postponed the whole thing and went to graduate school. I also harangued my friends endlessly. What am I going to do with my life? We sat up many late nights, listened to lots of deep, soul-searching music, like Where the Boys Are and Leader of the Pack. And we would throw in a little Bob Dylan on those nights when we wanted to feel really profound. And then, at one of those wonderful all-night girl talk parties, complete with pajamas and a record player, one of my friends said, "Oh, for heaven's sakes, Barbara, there's a big world out there. Just find something you feel is important to you and start." Best advice I was ever given. Find out what is important to you and start. Hindsight being 2020, I realized I could not make a decision because I was searching for something to do instead of believing in what I wanted to do. And God bless all those friends and family that said, "We believe in you." George Sand wrote in one of her letters that we must have a passion in life. For me, this has been and continues to be the key to life. Finding your passion. Searching your heart and soul for what really matters to you, and then acting on it. My passion is social justice, particularly social justice for women. It's been a driving force behind what I've chosen to do with my life. It has been the focus of many of my films and television programs. It has given me the ability to confront difficult questions about the lives that many women lead or are forced to lead, given me the courage to expose the issues, and the strength to search for solutions. I want to share with you today how I found my passion and how it continues to be the cornerstone of my life. Remember, passion is always a search for the ideal. In thinking about my life, I realized that I've had my share of luck. I now have the life I want, the life I set out to live when I was 10 years old. I am now close to being the person that I want to be. This is a hard-won gift from myself to myself. This has not come by accident. No one gave it to me. I paid for it every step of the way. But it has been and continues to be a deeply rewarding life. In William Goldman's film, The Lion in Winter, Peter O'Toole's grisly King Henry snarls at Eleanor of Aquitaine, "How from where we started did we ever get to this place?" And Katharine Hepburn's magnificent Eleanor hurls back, "Step by step." In my case, the answer would be plane by plane. And it all began at the age of 10. I was born in St. Paul, Minnesota, and I was blessed with parents who read. And each week, I couldn't wait until the Sunday New York Times would arrive, and I'd open the travel section. I'd see all these amazing places. And one day, I said to my mother, "So how do I get to all these places?" And my mother, being a wonderful no-nonsense Swede, said, "Well, you have three choices. One, you could be a diplomat." Now, for those people that know me, this was not a good idea. Not. Two, she said, "You could be a stewardess." Now, the concept of me serving coffee to anybody on someone else's schedule was like beyond the point. Not. Three, you could be a journalist. Now, this made sense, getting to see the world and getting paid for it. But upon reflection, I also realized that my mother gave me another great gift. In each of her suggestions, the assumption was that I would do it based on my own capabilities. My education, my job, my choices would get me there if I wanted. For that, I am eternally grateful. So off I went to Syracuse University to study journalism. This is where I was given a gift that gave meaning to my life. As Rudyard Kipling, another world-traveling journalist, says so eloquently in The Elephant's Child, "I keep six honest-serving men." Now, in my mind, I changed that to women. "They taught me all I knew. Their names are what and why and when and how and where and who." I learned to ask these questions of myself and the world around me. It is these questions that allow us to find our passion. The most important of these questions to me was why. When I asked why, I found my sense of social justice. I saw the stories around me that needed to be told and knew that I wanted to portray these stories on screen. I found my love for documentary filmmaking, and so my life's work began. I also found that my passion for travel fit wonderfully into this career. And I always maintain that your first true step into acting on your passion will stay with you for the rest of your life. At the end of my second year in university, I was chosen to be a participant in Operation Crossroads Africa. And they were sending me off to Nigeria. And when they told me that, at that point, I didn't even know where Nigeria was. And by the time I came home, I realized how much my life had changed. Over the years, I've returned to Africa many times, primarily to shoot individual documentaries and series. Just recently, I had the opportunity to return to the Gambia to be presented to the president. It was a very interesting trip, and even in 1997, my sense of social justice for women was given a personal workout. It took me about 20 minutes to convince the guards that even though I was a woman, I belonged upstairs with the other diplomats who were awaiting the president, not downstairs where, quote, the women were sent. Africa has given me a great deal of challenge and opportunity. To this day, when the plane touches down in almost any African country, I swear to you, they're the same baggage handlers, the same guys hustling for taxis. And for me, it's pure love. And this was just the beginning. My business manager and my former project accountant, two wonderful people who are here today, say that I personally keep my travel agent, Air Canada, and the phone companies in business. My assistant says that she can say hello, goodbye, and where is Barbara, in more languages than she ever thought she'd ever know. In addition to being able to follow my interests in social justice, my travels have given me many other great gifts. I have met many of the important people in my life on planes and in the far reaches of the world, including the Canadian Embassy in Jakarta, a Roman ruin in Morocco, a flight from Jakarta to Hong Kong, and the city of Winnipeg, have given me friends and loves that make my life very rich. I'm also very gifted with friends that like to travel with me. I'm very touched that many of these people are here today to share this special moment. Travel has given me also my sense of awe and wonder at the world we live in. You never lose that. To me, to be in the Piazza San Marco in Venice when all the tourists have gone home, to realize that the Arc de Triomphe in Paris is 15 to 20 times more beautiful in real life, to stand at the magnetic North Pole and be a few heart-stopping yards away from a polar bear as she surfaces and breaks through the ice, to be on a sailboat with the person you love and watch the sunset, to see the Swedish village that my great-grandfather left in 1867 in search of a better life in America, to feel the energy of the Berlin just after the wall came down, and to revel in the sheer physical beauty of Burma. Shwedagon Pagoda in Rangoon is brilliant gold and can be seen from anywhere in the city. My passion and the question why have also given me an opportunity to create work that hopefully, in some small way, leaves the world a better place. It has given me the courage to not shy away from difficult issues, the chance to showcase women from Canada and around the world who have made a commitment to social justice. In a documentary called Our Daughter's Pain, we asked why female genital mutilation is still practiced in Canada. In To Heal the Spirit, we confronted the issues of Native women in prison. And in Voices of Change, we were able to profile the lives of five female activists from around the world. Now, just a little plug here, my most recent TV program, which airs on Monday night, this coming Monday night, on News World at 8 o'clock Atlantic time, is called, now write all that down, is called The Balance of Power, and it's about being a female politician in Canada. We confront why there are so few female politicians in Canada. My newest question is why, in a country that talks about the value of children, is there still no national child care system, no serious initiatives on child poverty, and not even a comprehensive plan to end violence against women and children? I agree with Patricia Ireland of NOW, the National Organization for Women in the United States, when she says, women's vote, use it or lose it. The wonderful thing about why is that it reveals the work that still needs to be done. In asking why and taking action, I have also found that there is another valuable question. Why not? I have always loved George Bernard Shaw's words. There are those who see and ask why, and there are those who dream and ask why not. Why not was the slogan of the first International Women's Year and the name of my first company, and the question that allowed me to be part of the dream of creating WTN, the Women's Television Network. It was an exciting, stimulating, and challenging time. I started working on the application in 1993. We got the license on June 6, 1994, and we were on the air January 1, 1995. Now, I have it on strict authority that when TSN got licensed, they got all these tickets to football matches and hockey games, and they got brandy and cognac and cigars. And what did we get? Flowers and chocolates. Now, I won't go into how many boxes of chocolates we got, but we got a lot. And I can clearly remember the day I leapt up from my desk and I said to myself, no more chocolate, that's it. We knew that it was all meant in kindness, but let's face it, somehow it conjured up images of women eating chocolate, lounging on their sofas, watching TV. We, on the other hand, were women eating chocolate, working around the clock, and making TV. Come to think of it, I personally don't know any woman who has the time to lounge and eat bonbons. I did many radio interviews during the beginning of WTN and was inundated with an obvious question. Why isn't there a men's channel? At first, I responded with the appropriate political analysis, complete with facts and figures, that most of all the channels currently on the air were all run by men. This didn't seem to work. The calls increased. Why not a men's channel? Well, I said, what about TSN? Isn't that a men's channel? Really? Then all kinds of men phoned in saying, well, their wives watch TSN. So finally, fed up one day, I took the microphone and said, why isn't there a men's channel? Because nobody applied. There were no more calls. What we did not anticipate in that process was the depth of the backlash that we experienced. Our mission was to set up a channel where women could feel safe, where they would not see a woman being raped, mugged, and murdered every 3 minutes. A place where they would see positive role models. A place where women would drive the story. We were greeted with a wall of damning criticism, personal attacks, and vicious reports that were hard to take in. On one day, an article appeared where the writer, after a long assault on the very idea of a woman's channel, ended by saying that we were nothing more than a bunch of black lesbian feminists, as if any of those were actually insults. It was at this point that I stopped reading the reviews and we got on with the work. Within 1.5 years, I am proud to say the WTN is the number 2 ranked station among the new specialties, number 1 among women aged 18 to 45, and we were the first new specialty channel in that last batch of specialties that became profitable. And they said that. And they said there wasn't even enough women's programming to fill a schedule. Now, I joked earlier that I was only going to stick to the successes. But it's not been all sweetness and light. I've made many mistakes, hit dead ends, had financial difficulties, been forced to abandon projects that I really believed in. And I've had my share of days when I've looked up to the heavens and said, what am I doing? But no matter how lost I've become, my guiding light has always been my passion. 2 of the saddest words in the English language are, if only. Never regret. If it's good, it's wonderful. If it's bad, it's experience. We traveled through our lives moment to moment, step by step, choice by choice. Many of you here today have taken great leaps by choosing to invest in your own education. I encourage you to continue that journey. Take the time alone to think, to articulate your dreams. Don't get sidetracked into the pitfalls of things like body image. Mary Pfeiffer, in her newest book, Hunger Pangs, quotes one woman as saying, I used to want to be a Supreme Court judge. Now I just want to fit into a size 10 dress. Aim for health and strength, and don't be consumed by image. Personally, I've had an amazing year, and I have an amazing staff. We've produced several series and a number of specials, and even though I don't spend endless nights in the editing room anymore, I spend endless nights running a company and trying to figure out where the money's coming from. And I never get on a plane without a bag full of proposals because you never know if the person sitting next to you might be your next corporate sponsor. And that brings me to my next point. Ask for what you want. Dare to speak of what you dream. Let people know. We never do anything alone. Do not deny your friends and family and loved ones the experience of being shocked, appalled, and proud of what you set out to do. I have been blessed with colleagues, friends, and loved ones that have listened to me talk of my next project and joined me in saying, why not? Whatever your career choices, whether you choose to travel or to build a life and career here, begin each day with a deep sense of passion and a strong respect for yourself and what you can accomplish. You have much to offer. Take your education out into the world and make the world a better place. And as you continue to create your life, ask who and simply state me. Ask where and you will find the places that call to you. Ask when and you will understand the preciousness of each moment and answer now. Ask what and you will see the work that has to be done. Ask how, and you will find ingenuity and skills that you never knew you had. Ask why, and you will find your passion. Ask why not, and you will find your dreams. Build those dreams. Hold nothing back. I wish you Godspeed, safe journey, and a life well lived.
On behalf of the graduating class of 1997, I'd first of all like to congratulate you upon receiving your honorary degree from Mount St. Vincent University. It is an honor very well deserved, as is that of Ms. Patten. You must both be very proud of your accomplishments. Secondly, I would like to thank you for sharing your thoughts and for speaking with us today. I'm sure you've all found some insight from your achievements, your example, and your words. Thank you.
Just a brief announcement. Graduates and their families and guests are invited to a reception in the Rosaria Center as soon as the convocation ceremonies are concluded. So congratulations to all those who received degrees today, and thank you to all of you who came to be present at this convocation, making it the special event that it was this afternoon. And since we're all eager to talk to the graduates about their newly received degrees and the energy and effort that have brought them to this day and this time, as Chancellor of the University, I declare this convocation closed.